There's two key elements that make up the strength of the Samoan culture: family and religion, spiritual connection.
It's about giving, and it's about relationship. We help each other.
Food is a big part of our culture. In fact, food is love.
Traditionally, it's food from land and sea.
But we've been influenced, I guess, by the Western world and living a fast life. High fat, high starch, a lot of carbohydrates, high sugar.
I've got a brother that died, passed away because of diabetes.
I had gestational diabetes. A lot of family members have been diagnosed with diabetes and also on dialysis.
Losing your elders has a substantial cultural and social impact on that total community. And the community knows that, and they want to preserve the elders, obviously as part of their families, but also because they add the extra dimension of wisdom that comes in to make the right choices for that community.
When you look at medical complications that arise from diabetes, for every one person admitted to hospital from the general Australian population, there are seven that are admitted from the Samoan population.
Western Sydney University approached four churches within our community to be a part of the diabetes prevention project.
So this partnership is bringing together those community needs and aspirations with our expertise in preventing diabetes and its complications.
This program is all about building support to help lifestyle changes on a day-to-day basis.
We took the services into the community. We took the educational factor and what lifestyle change can do. We took that into the community.
Before starting this program, we found that 96% of the participants were overweight, and that 76% of participants were obese.
You drink water, eat healthy, train your body.
More vegetables, more fibre, more beans. It's good because my kids are watching their grandparents eat these things.
If, for example, someone does drop 15 kilos, 85% of those people, their diabetes will go into remission.
It speaks for itself. Mum doesn't have to take her diabetes medication anymore. She's lost about 40 kilos.
There is also a peer support element within this program that's really, really vital.
Every Saturday night, we do the Zumba. I like it because you are dancing and you exercise.
If you have people there by your side to help you make those changes, that can really help you maintain motivation. The improvements in blood glucose levels in those with diabetes were as much as you would expect from taking an extra medication.
This drop in glucose over time would mean that at least one in six complications would be prevented. So a lot less heart attacks, amputations, strokes, eye and kidney damage.
Western Sydney University is committed to conducting world-class research with its communities, not on its communities.
It's a scary thing for the community, but to get them to know exactly what it is and how to deal with it, it's something that we really need.
Our role as the university has been to facilitate the process, but the program now belongs to the community. It's their program, it's not ours. We're just there to help.
I thank this program that I learn a lot, so I want to teach my children, look after themselves. I don't want them to have diabetes.
I wish and hope that people would have the opportunity to join this program and see how good it is.